motorcycle is a machine that converts combustion into rotation. Unplug your TikTok for 7 minutes and you'll understand how every part works. The gas tank is kind of like a tank for gas. There's no combustion without a combustible.
On the bottom of our tank is a petcock, which is a cocky name for a tap. Off, on.
Fuel flows through this hose into the carburetor. Tough frickin' duh.
Carbs just force gas through jets because a spritz mixes better with air.
How much air you add is kind of like how long a teenager spends in the bathroom. It's entirely dependent on what you do with your wrist.
Twist the throttle open and it pulls a cable, which opens the carb to more airflow. More air, more boom, more fast.
That air comes from here, the air box. It's like a box for air.
By forcing our bike to breathe through the air box, we force it to breathe through the air filter. Otherwise, you get COVID-19 in your engine.
After combustion, we exhale through the exhaust.
This is your chance to save a polar bear, an old lady's eardrum, and a forest firefighter. Alternately, you could be a dick and cut your muffler off. And that is how a bike goes boom.
Combustion moves my ass, but not directly, thank God. This cushy seat softens the blow.
Combustion is violent for the engine too, so we call this a wet sump. Basically, your gears relax in a permabath of hot oil, like Arnold.
Some bikes have dry sumps, meaning there's a miserly old oil tank. It squirts just a bit of lubricant wherever needed and takes it back again.
Cheap bastard.
It's mainly spinny stuff we care to oil, and to get things spinning, you kick this. Kickstarter. Now, which cog would you like to spin, sir? First? Fourth? You need only boot this lowly servant called a gear lever. Whichever part of the transmission shaft you engage, it spins a countershaft, which is why we call this the counter sprocket. That, in turn, turns a chain, which turns the rear sprocket, which turns the rear wheel.
I could show you if I hadn't already pirated the chain for another video. Gyar.
Avast, matey. To stop the spinning, we pull this clutch lever.
The clutch cable pulls these friction plates apart, so the ones connected to the crankshaft can keep turning, while the ones connected to the transmission shaft can not. And that is how a bike gets spinny.
While the engine is rotating, we should make like squatters and steal power off it with this flywheel.
It's magnetic and turns with the crankshaft around these coils.
Remember high school science? If you spin magnets around coils, you get electricity, but nasty ass AC current with God knows what voltage depending on how fast you ride. So we send the buzz here.
Some imaginative little shit named this the rectifier regulator, because it rectifies alternating current into direct current and regulates voltage down to 12. Or 6.
Whatever your battery prefers. Of course, the spark plug is greedier. It wants like 20,000 volts. So in between, we have this ignition coil. Like Mac's girlfriend, it bottles up a bunch of energy, then unleashes a huge outburst on the spark plug.
Our headlight also runs off the battery, as does the speedometer.
Now, the only hand control we have left is this brake lever.
It pulls a cable, which pulls brake shoes against brake drum.
The same thing happens at your right foot with this brake pedal and connecting rod. Now, on newer bikes, you have pads instead of shoes, grinding against rotors instead of drums, and actuated by hydraulics instead of cables, but it's all the same. Friction slows you down. This is just the foot peg assembly.
And this is that foot brake I was yammering about. Of course, brakes are attached to wheels.
And with no wheels to steer, I have no need for the handlebar that steers them.
Nor the fenders, which stop them flinging mud in my face. Nor the suspension, which let them bounce around without bouncing me around. The back is just springs that let the swing arm swing. And the front is just forks. Ask any dork, they're also simple springs. In tubes. Thus, we put the power down. You can start rebooting your grinder gram now, we're almost home.
This is the frame. It holds the engine.
Our cylinder head is where the spark comes in. Our cylinder is where fuel and air come in. Then bang, combustion pushes the piston, rotating the crankshaft. And that is how combustion becomes rotation. Which, if you recall, is exactly what this machine is for.
And motorcycle. Thanks for watching.